It was in December 1955 that a very quiet, and I found when I met her, a very shy woman named Rosa Parks in Birmingham, Alabama, tired after a long day's work, decided not to give up her seat on a bus. And out of that quiet, tired, quiet, and courageous act was born a national movement, the Walk and Pray Bus Boycott of Montgomery, Alabama. After that, a movement with sit-downs, freedom riders, school enrollments, and much more swept the South and inspired the nation. Several months after the event in Montgomery, I had the pleasure of speaking to Rosa Parks in a small apartment in West Oakland where she was visiting. I asked her then what actually happened to set off this train of history, and this was her answer.
I left work on my way home December 1st, 1955, about 6 o'clock in the afternoon. I boarded the bus downtown in Montgomery on Coates Square. As the bus proceeded out of town, on the third stop, the white passengers had filled the front of the bus. When I got on the bus, the rear was filled with colored passengers, and they were beginning to stand. The seat I occupied was the face of the seat where the Negro passengers take as they on this route. The driver noted that the front of the bus was filled with white passengers, and there would be two or three men standing. He looked back and asked that the seat where I had taken, along with three other persons, one in the seat with me and two across the aisle, was seated. He demanded the seat that we were occupying. The other passengers very reluctantly gave up their seats, but I refused to do so. He then called the officers of the law. They came and placed me under arrest, and I was bailed out shortly after the arrest. And the trial was held December 5th on the next Monday, and the protest began from that day, and it is still continuing.
Well, Mrs. Parks, what in the world ever made you decide to be the person who, after all these years of Jim Crow and segregation, what made you at that particular moment decide you were going to keep that seat?
I felt that I was not being treated right, and that I had a right to retain the seat that I had taken as a passenger on the bus.
But Mrs. Parks, you had been mistreated for many, many, many years. You lived most of your life in Montgomery, Alabama. What made you decide at the first part of the month of December 1955 that you had had enough?
The time had just come.
Well, Mrs. Parks, had you planned this?
No, I hadn't.
It just happened.
Yes, it did. That I would be the person to do this. It hadn't occurred to me. Well, we didn't know just what to expect. In our area, we always try to avoid trouble and be as careful as possible to stay out of trouble along this line. I want to make very certain that it is understood that I had not taken a seat in the white section, as has been reported in many cases. The seat where I occupied, we were in the custom of taking this seat on the way home, even though at times on this same bus route, we occupied the same seat with white standing if there space had been taken up, the seats had been taken up, and I was very much surprised that the driver at this point demanded that I remove myself. step from the seat.
You have done something here that I didn't quite understand myself, namely this. You said that you did not take a seat in the white section, there's no doubt that has been reported in that way. What happened then, that you were in what is normally a colored section, and because whites had to stand up at this point, the driver asked you to get up to allow someone else to sit down.
Yes. Just come.